Hey, what's up, guys? This is Jesse Kaberkoff from Man. Hey, what's up, guys? This is Jesse Kaberkoff from A to Z Studios, and today I just wanted to go over a quick video with you guys. Not necessarily a quick video, but I know this is a question in the back of everyone's mind, and I just, recently finished tuning up my computer to the point where I can actually do it and give you guys a tutorial about it. But how do you get Adobe After Effects to render out faster? Now there's pretty much only one way you can do this, and that's by spending a little bit of money, unless you already have like a pre-built gaming computer, which I'll click somewhere over here. I'll put it right here, which skips forward to setting your Adobe After Effects. And but for now, I'm going to talk to you guys about things that you need for your computer. And we're going to start with your RAM. Now, you guys can pick up, I just picked mine up, an extra 4, 8, 16, 32 gigabytes, whatever, however many you think you need, how extra RAM for your computer. So, there's two things, RAM and your processor. Those go together hand in hand. I have an AMD A8. Quad core processor, so I have four cores, basically saying that I have four processors in one processor, and I have 8 gigabytes of RAM on my system. So basically the reason why I have that specific setup is because I do a lot of editing and it's the perfect setup for me. What Adobe has recommended to use Adobe After Effects in the rendering process, what they've recommended is 2 gigabytes per core or per processor that you have. So I have 4 cores, 8 gigabytes of RAM. Each core gets two gigabytes of RAM, which I have noticed a dramatic difference in the rendering with that alone. And then not only the RAM that you need, you also need a good graphics card or a GPU. And I do recommend, if you're on a budget, the AMD XFX R6670. This is a great graphics card. I only spent about $60 on it, and I can't complain about it. I wish I could afford the R7 7770, but it's what I have. And the reason why I have this 2 gigabytes of memory dedicated for the graphics, which allows you to render out video a lot faster, and also if you're a gamer like me, you can also play games on your PC, because I just started getting into PC gaming and I noticed a huge difference when I switched to an actual dedicated graphics card instead of running it off my motherboard like an idiot. And the reason why I also recommend AMD the Core Edition is because of the disc that it comes with. Let me move my screen over here. It comes with this. If it loads, there it is. Whenever you install it, you get the AMD Vision Engine Control Center, and you get this right here. So if you go to start, let's go to start. It's because I'm recording. But if you go to start at the very beginning right here, and you go to you scroll down to your performance, you have ADM or AMD Radeon Dual Graphics, and click on that. Whenever that loads. And basically what this allows you to do is use your APU with your GPU, and it creates faster processing, so you get better video, and it also helps out with your Adobe After Effects. That's just something cool that AMD has incorporated. If you have an AMD board that, I think it has to have the Crossfire technology, but that's if you have AMD. So if you have AMD like processor and AMD Crossfire motherboard or Crossfire ready motherboard, then it'll allow you to do that, and it's really cool because it allows for better graphics. Now, along with your graphics card, a lot of people forget that, especially if you're new to computers and you're just really looking to get After Effects, you kind of got to know about computers. So when you get a new GPU or graphics card, you also have to upgrade your power supply. This is the old power supply that I had in my computer. This is a 300 watt power supply. This GPU that I have right here requires a 400 watt power supply. So I went out and Best Buy picked up that 400 watt power supply. And just keep in mind, guys, if you do upgrade past the 6670, which is the one that I have right now, if you go with like the 7770 or the 7870, you need like a 450 to a 500 watt power supply. So obviously, you're going to need a bigger upgrade than just a 400 watt. Put that there. Okay, and then obviously, you know, the megahertz that your CPU is running at is an important thing. I recently overclocked mine to 2.8 gigahertz instead of 2.4 gigahertz, basically saying how many processes it's allowing to process per second. So 2800 megahertz is a lot faster than 2400 megahertz, obviously. Okay. And then the last thing is your hard drive. The most important thing, because Adobe After Effects, if you're using CS6, Adobe After Effects CS6 allows for pre-pixel rendering. Basically, what it allows you to do is, I have here, I have two hard drives on my computer. One is my primary hard drive to actually load my system and my Windows, and the second one, I mainly use it as my disk cache, so I can save all of my frames from Adobe After Effects. And what I'm going to show you right now, I'm going to pull this up. This is MadPanda503's intro, and the reason why I'm using this one is because it's a lot heavier with the graphics than any other video that I have right now, because of all these individual 3D objects. It makes it a lot harder to process out. And what I'm telling you right now is the reason why I have this disk cache is because every time, say I skip to this frame right here, it'll automatically save this frame into my disk cache, and then every time I go to a different frame, it'll save that one. But when I want to go back to this one, or the one that I was just on, it'll automatically pull it off the disk cache and automatically render it out for me, so it'll remember what it was. And the faster hard drive you have, the faster it's going to come to right here. And it uses the same process for rendering on your final renders. So I would recommend a solid state drive because they transfer extremely fast. But if you don't have one of those, just look for a hard drive that has a higher RPM or revolutions per minute, whatever it is on PC. A higher RPM and a higher transfer rate, so you can actually get a faster rendering on your computer, because it will render as fast as your computer can pull the information off the hard drive. Okay. Now, there are a few things that you can do in Adobe After Effects to actually make it a little bit faster too. This is the part where I told you to click forward, and I thank you for joining me. What we can do is you can go to Edit and Preferences, and then you can go straight down to Media and Disk Cache. And this is where you will allocate some of your memory on a different hard drive. I wouldn't recommend using your primary hard drive or your backup hard drive, because you obviously have a lot of other information being pulled off at the same time, reducing the amount of data that can be allocated straight for Adobe After Effects. So what I went ahead and did is I made a special folder just for Adobe After Effects, and I allocated 100 gigabytes of it to this, so I can save up to 100 gigabytes of frames. And anybody who knows how small a frame is in file size, that's a lot of frames. But it also makes it easier, that way I don't have to worry about it, and I'll always have room. And then we'll hit OK, and we'll save it in there. And then the last thing that we can do in Adobe After Effects is go to your memory and multiprocessing, if you're still in here. If you're not still in here, just go to Edit, Preferences, and Memory and Multiprocessing. Okay. Now, in our memory section, it says that I have installed in 7.5 gigabytes of RAM. Okay, and I'm supposed to have 8, but it says 7.5. What I want to do is reserve as much RAM as I can for my programs in Adobe. For some reason, it won't let me just deselect all the rest of these. I'd like to allocate 6 gigabytes of RAM to Adobe After Effects, but I can't do that. And the reason why this is set to 1.5 RAM reserved for other applications is because when I am rendering in Adobe After Effects, or I'm doing some editing work in Adobe After Effects, it'll still allow me to use other applications, because if I reserve all of my RAM just for Adobe After Effects, I won't be able to use any other applications. So I set that to as small as it would go, which is 1.5. I wish you could allocate something smaller, but 1.5 gigabytes is not too bad. Allocating 6 gigabytes of RAM to Adobe After Effects isn't bad either. And the last thing you can do, if you're still in that file or still in the preferences section, you can select render multiple frames simultaneously. Okay, now basically this is telling me right here I have four CPUs. This is my quad core processor right here. And what I want to do is I want to allocate all four processors to Adobe After Effects while it's rendering out, which is giving it faster. So I have four processors rendering at the same time. And what it allows me to do is multiple frames at one time, so I can render, I think if I remember correctly, however many frames is the same amount as your processor. So if I have four cores, it'll render four frames at the same time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the reserved RAM or reserved CPU for other applications. I'm going to set that to zero because I don't care about the other applications. And then we're going to set this as small as it'll go. So we'll give 0.75 gigabytes of RAM to every other application so we don't have to worry about it. We're allocating as much RAM and CPU we can to Adobe After Effects to get fast editing and fast rendering. And that is actually it. I'm not going to render out in this video right here. I did a lot of tests. you can see my last time for Mad Panda, like the first time that I did it without doing anything that I just explained right now, it took 53 minutes and 54 seconds for a 15-second video, which is absolutely crazy, and now I can render this in under 10 minutes. All the rest of these are just me testing out different settings. but thank you guys for watching. I hope this guys helped you. I hope this really helped, because I know everybody is always looking for a better and faster way to render out in After Effects. And if you guys have any other questions, please feel free to let me know. You can message me on Twitter, twitter.com/adigitstudios. You can go to Facebook. All the links will be in the description if you ever want to message me. You can also leave a link in the description below. And make sure you guys do like this video. Make sure you guys do subscribe. And I hope you guys really enjoy this video. Thanks, guys, for watching. And I will see you later.